changed now. I'm made new. I have to say goodbye. For I will say goodbye. All things created, but the old man dies. He tries power, but the flesh controls. I'm tried by the fire. Here go, here go. Man, I turn away from my past life, cause my past life was all up in that fast life. Switching, changing lanes, amazing I ain't crashed right. Quit the salvation, but I ain't even asked right. Until one day I came face to face with my maker. Glory, hallelujah, almighty creator. Then I saw this a hunger and thirst. But he told me that you gotta start killing that old man first. So living righteous, if it wasn't for the law, I wouldn't have known that sin exists. I ain't got a mansion, but I got a room in it. My house needed clean, so we put a broom in it. And now I let the spirit move in it, lead and guide my way as I die daily.
All the things that I would do, feel like I couldn't. All the things that I should do, feels like I shouldn't. Human nature has to. Just gotta kill this flesh.
All the things that I would do, why I feel like that I couldn't. All the things that I should do, man, why I feel like that I shouldn't. Only understand it though, but if I suppose explain the best that human nature got dual natures. That's why I gotta kill this flesh.
I have to say goodbye to you, so I'll say goodbye.
Ears ain't never heard, eyes ain't never seen. It hasn't even hit my mind, all the things he has waiting for me.
Ears ain't never heard, eyes ain't never seen.
Shalom, shalom, Israel. Blessings to you all, saints of the Most High. Right, how we coming in your area, saints? All right, we got tens all over the board. Thank you all for that feedback. Thank you. Well, greetings to you all that be scattered abroad. Beloved of Yah, called to be saints. Grace and peace be unto you from Yahweh our Father and Yahshua our Mashiach. Hallelujah. Bless y'all on this beautiful first day it is here in Tennessee. I am your host for the evening, Elder Donnie. And I want to welcome you all to this broadcast, to this edition of Block Straightway Truth on Block Talk Radio. So it's a pleasure and an honor to be here with you in fellowship. And as I always say, it is an honor to and a privilege to serve you, Israel, Yahweh's chosen people, his remnant. You know, Yahweh called you the apple of his eye. You are a peculiar people. Hallelujah. And so that I take that as no small thing. So I give thanks and praise to the Father. All glory and honor belongs unto Yahweh. Because without him, I mean, hey, none of us will be here. So we give him all the praise and honor and the glory. And we'll be careful to give him all the praise, honor, and the glory. Hallelujah. Just want to send out a few acknowledgments to Pastor Dow, our shepherd, who works tirelessly and labors tirelessly for, you know, to feed Yahweh's sheep. Blessings unto you and your house. Also to the other pastors associated with Straightway Truth, Pastor Fox, Pastor Tatum, as well as Pastor Core. Blessings to you all. Also to Teacher Shane McKnight and all of the elders. Bless you all. Hallelujah. You know, saints, I pray that you all are encouraged on this first day of the week, and that you all are, you know, restored whole, restored new, and that you had a productive day throughout this day, you know, getting ready to, as we proceed on with the rest of the week. You know, I realized something, that we're truly blessed to have that set apart day in which we have, which is the Sabbath, the seventh day of the week, which many don't believe in, but we do. The remnant, we believe, and it's so vital to us. It's so important that we really use that day for what it's designed for us to rest. You know, I reflect and I think back on, you know, the heathen, how they, you know, the reason they have no peace, the reason they have no joy in their hearts, you know, they are just buck wild. You know, we see them all the time. The reason is because they do not have any rest. They do not take a day to rest their bodies from all of the cares of this life, all the garbage that's being put in them. There's no filter. There's no purification, nothing. And so they go from day to day, you know, week to week, month to month, just with the buildup and the pileup of garbage and filth and uncleanness. But we have a special time, a set-apart day for us, Israel, in which the Father himself rested on this day. Hallelujah. Just this morning, I was over at Straightway on the land, and I had to restore the mailbox, to fix it from the from the vandalism and that happened to it. And while I was working on it, you know, there was a brother that was up. You know, he was at the guest house. And he heard a loud noise and like commotion going on. Mind you, I heard it and I already knew what was going on. So he ran out and he was like, "Hey, you know, brother, is everything all right? What's that I hear?" I said, "Oh, don't worry about that. That's just the heathen, you know." I said that that's just the heathen, the neighbors, and I showed them, you know. I said they live right here. They live real close, and that's just them being themselves, you know. And you know, is it like I was saying? There's just no rest, no peace in their hearts and their minds. I mean, you just should have heard the filth coming out of their mouths. Not only that, but then they begin to play loud music. Just I never heard country rap. I heard it today for the first time. But you fill yourself with garbage. You fill yourself with filth, and then you have no type of filter, no type of way for this stuff to exit. And so you just basically full of garbage, full of shit, really. And so we just give praise and honor and thanks to the Father for all that he is doing for us in this hour. It's evident that the Father loves us and that he is still working with his people, Israel. You know, from the message alone just yesterday, that really shows us the level of care that the Father has for us, because he's going to have a holy set apart people. I don't know if y'all getting it, you're grasping all of the information that's coming forth from the pulpit as of recently, But, you know, the Father's really, he's really trying to get his people ready, trying to get us prepared. You know, every time I pray that the Father will really, truly uncover in my life and show me if there's anything that's hidden in my heart, anything that's hidden that I'm not aware of, that I should repent of, or that I'm falling short in a certain area. You know, Father, reveal it unto me. You know, I pray that often, especially on that Sabbath morning when we are about to enter into the tabernacle on our drive there. And I just ask the Father, you know, to reveal it. If there's any rebuke, if there's any correction, chastisement, hey, allow us to receive it. Not shy away from it, not run from it, but embrace it. You know, and sure enough, on yesterday, we heard it yet again. There's nowhere for us to run. There's nowhere for us to hide with messages such as the one we had on yesterday, saints. You know, we really need to take heed to the warning, take heed to the instruction and the teachings, because it is, they're jewels. They really are jewels, and they are there to help us to sanctify ourselves, and so that we're ready. You know, a bride adorned, a bride that is ready for a master. Hallelujah. So I'm just thankful, saints. I really, truly am. And as I was sharing with a brother, I couldn't really articulate it, but I was trying to explain that I really see that the Father is really, truly moving us. We're growing. We're going to different levels, you know, in this thing. And, you know, we can't sit around and continue, you know, with the same mindset of the past or doing the same old things we did just last year. Because let's face it, saints, we don't have, you know, 20 years to get this thing. We got to get this thing now, saints. You wonder why so much information is being brought forth. And sometimes it might seem like it's so much, it bombards you. I can't keep up. But you know what? If you just take time and you sit down and you really chart it out and see in what areas I can, you know, devote time to studying, devote time into going over the messages, you'll be surprised how much junk that's in your schedule throughout the day and throughout the week that you can really eliminate. You know, I talked about it last week. A lot of those things you can really, you know, they are things that you put before the Father. A lot of times not even knowing. You know, you might come home and tired, exhausted, and you want to just kick back and pop something. Nah. Better hit your knees, man. You better talk to the Father. Let him know. You know what I mean? Do. There's many things you can do, but when we get what we call free time, we want to just relax. And we, you know, that's my time. It's me now. Nah, it doesn't work like that. You know, don't forget we're servants. We are truly servants of the Most High Yah. And we need to really understand that and get that, saints of the Most High. But today is going to be a little different. You know, I want to do something different with the show today. As I was just speaking about servants, you know, we have some very good examples before us of servants. We have one in particular that I want to speak about. Excuse me, saints. There was a video that was done just a while ago by Pastor Dow. And I can't remember the title of the video. All I can remember is what he talked about in the video. He said that it was a video thanking Pastor Fox. And in that video, he said, you know, we shouldn't wait until a person is gone before we honor him or before we say thank you. You know, that's one of those things, you know, a lot of times we can take it for granted, just appreciating a brother or even a sister for something that they've done for us. You know, nothing's wrong with that. We are family. But remember that. We are Yisrael. We are family. And there's nothing wrong with giving thanks, giving praise. You know, but one thing we need to remember, too, is that Yahweh, he gets all the praise and all the glory for all things that we do. And it's only because of him. You know, because of that promise that he made with our forefathers. And he is a man of his word, and he's holding true to that promise. And so he sends us a pastor, such as Pastor Dow, a man who is unselfish, a man who gives all. You know, the world, they can't even see it. All they can see is what their wicked hearts allow them to see. They're blinded. But we, Israel, especially us men in Israel who are waking up in this hour, you know, we understand and we know for a fact where we come from. And we know the changes that have been going on in our lives that have taken place and that has taken place in our lives. We all have become better men who really are associated with this ministry and who really truly are striving, who really are striving to enter in at the straight gate. You know, we understand. And I want to take this time on this broadcast tonight while I have the opportunity. I want to say thank you, Pastor Dial. Thank you for all that you have done, all that you do for Israel. I thank the Father for giving you strength to do these things. You know, you have truly been an inspiration to me. You have truly helped me along this way. I've never seen a man like, you know, who possessed the type of character, the type of work ethic. I can't say it enough. Unselfishness. You give all. You know, I can remember once where I was, you know, in a church, Christian church, and I asked. I was really seeking. I was like, man, you know, I asked some of the ministers. I asked, could you help me out and just show me what books or what material, what software you use in your studies, just to help me out. You know, I really got nothing. Then a few days later, I got this broke down program software that don't even work no more. It's not even in existence. But that's all it could provide for me. But I come this way, and Pastor Dial not only does one, two, three or more videos showing us the material, the books, and the things in which you use and study. I mean, you think about it. As I think about it, just last week, I was over at the land just helping out, you know, and Pastor Dial just took it up on it. You know, he asked me, always saying, inquiring about how we're doing, and he asked me, he said, so, you know, have you been checking out the progress of the garden, the greenhouse, and everything on the land from week to week? I said, yes, I have been. Matter of fact, I make it a point to go and check it out to make sure to see how the tomatoes are doing and the peppers and stuff. And he said, well, let me show you something. You may not notice. And he showed me something about the tomatoes. And it's very simple, but it was just hands-on. It was just the fact that he showed me that. He took time out from what he was doing to show me how to do a particular thing. All right? And that's valuable. That really, truly is. I'm going to say this, but my own dad, I remember coming to, when I was preparing to come to Straightway for the first time, and I explained to him all the different things that I was going to learn and that was going to be offered, you know, survival prep, you know, they were going to have chicken butchering classes, how to start fires, and different things like that, you know, gardening and so on and so on. Do you know what my dad told me? He said, well, yeah, you know, I know about all of that stuff, you know, because, see, he grew up on an island. And they, you know, they had to fend for themselves. They lived off the land. They knew about these things. You know, I thought it was just so weird that I had to go. I had to travel all these different across all these different states to Tennessee to find out, to learn these different things. Well, here, my dad already knew these things. And see, that's what I'm saying. You know, the unselfishness of Pastor Darwin. I appreciate that. I greatly appreciate that. So, I just want to say thank you. You know, I don't have anything scripted on this part. I'm just really speaking from the heart and just as it comes to my mind and my heart, I spit it out, but I'm just grateful. And just the knowledge of precious metals, you know, of going deeper and having a deeper and personal relationship with the Father and just being real committed. You know, Pastor Dial makes it cool, if you will, to serve the Father. He really does, you know, to talk about the Father all the time, just to constantly have that conversation. And these are things that I watch from him, and I admire these things, and I appreciate it. And I just heard him say just recently that we need mentors. We definitely do, and I know I do. But I'm blessed, saints, if you can't even tell. And if you, you know, I think it's just time, you know. And what I want to do, I'll get into that in a minute, but I'm not going to run my mouth too much. I want to hear from the men in Israel. I want to hear your testimony. I want to hear what you have to say. If there's anything on your heart that you would like to say, you know, because I'm sure your lives have been impacted as well. And but as it says, Isaiah 42:8, it says that I am Yahweh. That is my name. And my glory I will not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. And so as I stated early on in the broadcast, we give all praise and honor to the Father, because without him, we couldn't do none of this. None of us would be here. Hallelujah. And so we are careful to give him the praise. King David, he said, I will praise thee, O Yahweh, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. Ecclesiasticus 7:29-30, it says, fear Yahweh with all thy soul, and reverence his priest. Love him that made thee. You hear that, right? It says, love him that made thee with all thy strength, and forsake not his ministers. You hear that, right? Forsake not his ministers. You know, I can remember early on when I first came into this truth, I would often hear Pastor Dow say, he would remind us to know our Yah. He said, know your Yah. He said, because I'm not your Yah. Know him. And I thought that was, I was blown away by it. I was like, oh, hallelujah. Putting things in perspective. Hallelujah. Proverbs 27:2 says, let another man praise thee, and not thine own mouth, a stranger, and not thine own lips. Hallelujah. And we often hear Pastor quote that. But like I was saying earlier, there's nothing wrong with giving honor and saying thank you, because it is due, you know. And you know, we hear all this negativity, we see all the negativity, you know. And I know Pastor, you know, he probably don't even some of that stuff he just got to ignore, because it's just so outlandish, it's foolish to even entertain some of that stuff. But you know, we see all that goes on. You know what I do on Sabbath evening broadcast. Blog Talk Radio. I log on to online church, and you can actually see the video. And I know a lot of you also do the same. And you know, I can see, you know, that pastor's tired. You can see, you know, that he's been laboring hard, but he's still going at it. And if you saw just last week on this past broadcast, Sabbath evening, he just was singing and was merry in his heart, just thankful. And thanking the Father. You know, it's a beautiful sight to see. And it's just an example for us all, you know, that we can learn from. We have a true example live here in the flesh. You know what I mean? So I'm just thankful, saints. Hallelujah. Proverbs 25:27 says, it is not good to eat much honey. So for men to search their own glory, it is not glory. All right, I'm gonna read a couple scriptures, and I'm gonna go straight to the phone lines, saints. I'm gonna let the men of Israel speak. Let you be heard. Let you have a voice in this as well. Before we get there, let's see. Give me 1 second, saints. All right, the guest calling number. It is 310-982-4226. That's 310-982-4226. So go ahead and get in the caller queue if you have anything you want to say, anything you want to share, you have any testimonies. You're free to do so, thanks to the Most High. But as I was going to Sirach, that's 11:3-4, and it says, the bee is little among such as fly, But her fruit is the chief of sweet things. You know, I had to think about that. I was like, what in the world? But it's just basically stating, like the Messiah said, you know, those that are great among you, they are the least. And as in Matthew 23:11, it says, but he that is greatest among you shall be your servant. All right. Sirach 11 and verse 4 says, boast not of thy clothing and raiment, and exalt not thyself in the day of honor. For the works of Yahweh are wonderful, and his works among men, they are hidden. All right. So I'm going to go to one more thing, son. One more thing while we at it. All right. John 15 through 17. And it reads, so when they had dined, Yeshua said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He said unto him, yea, master, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my lambs. He said to him again, the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? He said unto him, yea, master, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my sheep. He said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, master, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. And Yeshua said unto him, feed my sheep. Glory to the King. So, saints, we know for a fact that our pastor, that he loves the Father, that he loves him dearly, excuse me, because he holds back nothing from us. He feeds us very well. And he even says that as he gets the revelation, as he gets greater understanding, overstanding of something, then he's going to present it to us. He's going to give it to us. And we all can attest to that, that our lives have been changed dramatically, you know, by coming this way. What a way to be awakened. What a way to have your eyes open. You know, I was just talking to a brother after Sabbath, and I was telling him just about the level of passion that I see when Pastor Dow preaches or when he does anything. It's just it's so strong. And I can only wonder and only think about our ancients of old, you know, like King Dawid and you know, even Moses. You think about when he came down from that mountain and he saw Israel and the state that they were in and what they were doing while he was up there spending time with the Father. That the level of that you can call that righteous indignation for sure. But you think that sometimes in how we get rebuked and how pastor comes across with the messages, how strong and passionate they are. I can only think about them. And when I see that in them, I'm just like, wow, look at that. It's just so strong and passionate. But, you know, it's just encouragement, though, for us all, saints of the Most High. I can't stress it enough how blessed we are that the Father would give us all, you know, these gifts that he's blessed us with. You know, not only that, but I want to say thank you also. I want to give another thank you to Elder Becker. I want to say thank you because, you know, Elder Becker, he's always giving, always working, giving of himself, giving of time for the saints, all for the saints. And for me personally, always there to listen whenever I have things that I may not understand or things that I'm going through, and he's there to listen and always willing to give advice. Very wise, very knowledgeable, and I'm thankful, and I just want to say thank you, Elder Becker, for all that you do, not only for myself, but for all of Israel. Also, Teacher Shane, you know, always giving as well, always. You know, this man gets off from work and just hits it. You know, he has so many different tasks and so many jobs that he's doing. Shoot, he's all over the place. But I'm thankful for him as well. Always there to listen as well and give advice. I appreciate it. You know, I'm thankful, too, for the pastors that are associated with Straightway, because you all give a lot as well. And I'm thankful for you, Pastor Joe Fox, Pastor John Tatum, and Pastor Corey. I appreciate it. You know, the phone calls and just encouragement. And it's good to see that passion as well with you all. And so we're truly blessed in Israel. You know, my beloved brothers, each and every last one of you, you know, from the days back when we were doing Skype, just all wee hours of the night, you know, just, you know, learning from each other. It's just been a ride, you know, all the way up to now, all the brethren that I'm meeting now. I'm so thankful for you all, you know, your encouraging words, your prayers. It's just awesome. And I'm thankful for my family, Israel. You know, I thank all the sisters in Israel for all the hard work that they do in taking care of all brethren, taking care of Straightway and doing all that they do. You know, a lot of times you don't get to see, you know, certain people, but they have a very instrumental roles in this ministry. And I just want to say thanks to everyone. You know, trying to get through this thing. Just this week I'm at work. Oh, man, I'm thinking about all of this. And imagine I'm at work working around, you know, number of men, and I have tears in my eyes. I'm literally crying. You know, and but I'm not concerned. I'm not worrying about who's watching. You know, they don't understand anyway. So, but I just want to thank you all, Israel. And I'm just blessed to know you all on this side of glory. And hallelujah. Bless y'all. I'm going to take a break real quick and come back to the phone lines. Be right back, Sai.
Shalom. This is Sister Wenda. I hope that all of you are enjoying this particular broadcast that you're listening to right now. We really appreciate each and every last one of you, our faithful listeners and supporters of the Straightway Truth radio broadcast. We try to make sure we do our best to ensure that you have the best broadcast as well as the truth coming to you in the hour that we're living in right now. If you'd like to help us in this endeavor, your offering will be greatly appreciated in the work of the Ministry of the Most High Yah. Our mailing address for your gift, offering, or letter of support is Pastor Charles Dowell, Jr. That's Pastor Charles Dowell, Jr., 632 Highway 52 Bypass West. That's 632 Highway 52 Bypass West, PMB number 1, Lafayette, Tennessee. And Lafayette is spelled Lafayette, Tennessee, 37083. If you would like to contact us by way of phone, the country code is 1, area code 615-688-3025. You may leave a message there, and be the Father's will, we will do whatever we can to return your message. It is our hope and our prayer that as you continue to listen to the Straightway Truth Ministry, and as you apply the teachings of this ministry, that you are finding peace and growth within you, your family, and life as well. And do please tell others so that the truth may also have an impact and touch others' lives so that they may enjoy the benefits of the truth of Jesus Christ, just like we all are. Shalom, the King is coming.
All right, Saints, we're back here on the Straightway Truth here on Blog Talk Radio. I'm your host, Elder Donnie here. And Saints, You all know I'm just grateful and thankful. And so, you know, I won't talk too much. I'll go ahead and I'll go to the phone lines and see what the brethren have to say. Hallelujah. All right, we'll go to the first, the first caller here. Area code 347. 347, you're here on the Straightway Truth on Block Talk Radio. How can I help you?
Shalom.
Hey, shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom, shalom. Can you hear me, Brother Junior? Junior.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
I had a thing pass. Thank you for me challenging me to get stronger in faith. Being a man, be tough. Father bless you.
Brother Junior, hold on one second, Brother Junior. Look, see if you could, your phone is breaking up real bad. Let me see if I can, I'm going to come right back to you, all right, Junior? See if you can get, because you did it the other night. I guess you got another spot or whatever, but you came through clear the second time. But it's breaking up real bad. I can't even understand.
Give me a moment. Give me a minute.
Yeah, I'll wait. I'll wait. Go ahead. Do what you need to do. All right, hallelujah there. International Junior. Junior. Oh, hallelujah, saints.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir. Good?
Yes, sir. I can hear you. Go ahead.
Perfect.
Go ahead and talk.
That I was saying, he encouraged me to get stronger, be a man, getting strong in the faith. And Father bless me, true brethren, too. True brethren. See that? Think, Pastor, correct me in certain areas. Man, correct me in certain areas and all burning straightway, correct me in other areas. I'll not be here. Be doing my thing. Thank the elders for, inspiring me to get stronger too. For their messages, everything, including you, my brother, my elder.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for all for it. Yes, sir. I thank for messages. Yesterday message is beautiful message too. All your messages are beautiful. I thank him for that. I thank the Father for him sending me here. Because ain't none out there in the world, none out here in the world, nothing. But alive in DC. The same old crap. Over and over and over again. Now I got a family now.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yes, sir. I always differ from people. Like, I know something's going to happen in my life. The Father burned the word, right? But you always different from different. You always different from a lot of people, in like school, whatever. Something's going to happen in your life, and this happened. I know something's going to happen in my life, so I'm here. Look at it.
Hmm.
See where I'm coming from?
Yes, sir. You said you knew something was going to happen, huh?
Yes, sir. Something deep is going to happen. Like, something deep is going to happen in my life now. I'm here. Bam. I could test that, Brother Scott said, too. Like he knew he wasn't there for football and whatever. Just something deeper in the purpose. Something here for a deeper purpose. And he found out.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
I think the Father has, changed my mind. Like, come out of the city to the country, it's better. Country's best way of living. City is distraction. I don't feel right.
Mm-hmm.
It's two different between the city and the country. I understand. I seen someone like the heathens, you know, playing music. Yesterday, you know, they parties, nighttime, every Saturday night. You know what I mean? It's crazy. You know what I mean? Especially getting warm out, you know what I mean? It's crazy. Country is peace. You can think. You can think more. The Father will receive you more, too. And the
right.
Country is in the city. Sir, that's all I had. Thanks so much for this call. You stay encouraged, Elder. And shalom. Take care. I love you.
Shalom. Love you, too. Hallelujah. Love you, too.
Yes,
shalom. Thank you, brother.
Shalom.
Hallelujah. That was our brother Junior, that beloved brother Junior. Junior always the same. He stays the same. You know, he doesn't flip-flop on you. Hallelujah. Just a faithful brother. And you're right, brother Junior, man. It's totally different. It's totally peaceful out there in the country. From there, we're going to go to area code 614. You're here on the Straightway Truth on Blog Talk Radio. How can I help?
Shalom, Elder Donnie.
Shalom. Shalom, my brother. Brother Mike?
This is Brother Mike. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You have, you changed all my plans today. You asked us to call him out, Pastor Dow, and, while I was waiting, I tried to write some things down because I didn't want to forget anything. I put up my Bible to the book of Acts. I might have to call you back next week. I'm going to try to get through this, Elder.
Yes, sir.
But, I met Pastor at a time where I had made plans. I can speak about those plans now because those plans are not my plans anymore. But I'd had enough of Christian churches. You know, I've been around, played in small churches. I've played for some drums for some of the big churches. And every time it'd be a big letdown. Every damn time. Every time it'd be a big letdown. And I knew they just weren't preaching the truth because I could see what little I could see. So I knew I was looking for a man. And some of my prayers were answered when I was a heathen, things that I prayed for. But year after year, ever since I was 9 years old, I've been watching people go down on Sunday, walk down for that in need of prayer. They walk down to the pulpit, and, you know, people in need of prayer. Since I was 9 years old, I'm 51 now, and I ain't never seen one result. But the Father does bless the heathen. Also, I've seen people get blessed and get healed. But for the most part, nothing, no action, no nothing. So I was at a time in my life when I met Pastor. I had been keeping the Sabbath for 11 years. And as far as I knew, I'm going to go to hell keeping the Sabbath because there was nothing else. I couldn't learn nothing else. I could only understand some of the scriptures that was on the surface. I thought thou shalt not kill was one of the easy ones. Well, you just don't kill. No, when you get to a man of Yah, you'll understand differently. There is a time to kill. But when a man of Yah go behind that word, behind that scripture, and bring forth truth and tell you thou shalt not murder, then your eyes start to open. Mm-hmm. Pastor Dow's opened my eyes to so many things by the way he lived, not by just the way he preached. That's how he teach me, through the foolishness of preaching. But he also teach me by the way he lived. I mean, what a brother. This man sold everything and moved outside the city to the country and lived really primitive for many years, many, many, many years, and took care of a lot of people. There's been a lot of people come and go on that land. At one time, there were 70 people on that land that he was responsible for. And that's what I couldn't find out in the world, was a man that was a man of Yah that would be responsible.
Sure.
I find that all these preachers today, they shield themselves and give themselves a veil to hide behind, especially if you start talking about that money.
Sure.
Oh, I don't collect the money. I don't know. I don't. Well, how come the hell you don't? You the leader. You say you the leader. You say this your plot. How come the hell you don't know nothing about the damn money? But in my brother, Pastor Dow, I see what he do. He take responsibility for that. He answer for that. He know that in so many of his responsibilities, he is charged to look out for my soul. He has been given rule. If I submit myself to Yah, him, you too, you an elder, and some people have a problem with your age, but if they go with the scripture and if they truly believe in the Most High, they won't even see your age.
Yes, sir.
And a true man of Yah, in the way he live, in the way he teach, in the way he preach, and them calluses on his hands. I mean, he get after it. He has truly been blessed by the Most High. How do I see these blessings? No, it ain't no big bank accounts that fall on T.D. Jakes and all these other ones. The Most High blessed his hands, and you can see where that tabernacle started, where they used to fellowship, and look where we fellowshipping now.
That's right.
He built that, him and the brother. The Most High blessed their hands. And that's another thing I learned. So many people in this world are running after these preachers, giving alms to them, thinking, if I give to this preacher, these Sunday preachers, then I'll be rich just like
him.
When pastor teach, well, all that he give me, I will teach you. And then expect us to teach others. He's not building up and storing up for himself. He's building up men of Yahweh. And as you'll never see somebody, another man, come and admit, okay, I've been given more light. I've been given more understanding. This is now what we need to do. Or this is now what this means. Or this is now. That ain't going to never, ever change what come out their lips and tell the truth. But I found a true man of Yah. I really did. And I'm so thankful for it. I found a man and a ministry that I can support. And I am truly thankful for it. All our life is now in this household, it's about Yahweh. And where is Yahweh? He's in us, in this ministry. And he's showing me who's my brother and who's not. But I don't judge that, because every time I think I know something, I find out I don't know shit.
Sir.
But I'm truly thankful. I'm thankful for you, brother. I'm thankful for pastor. I'm thankful for my elders. I've been shown lately how the men, not pastor, not the elder, but the men, I've just been shown lately, and I haven't opened my mouth, that we're not as strong as I thought we were. And that we really need to get it together. So we have some other things come up on our plate this Shabbat, and we stuck with that and dealt with that. But we were going to start, so we will probably start during this week. Brother Jermaine and I and the men in Ohio, we are going to start praying for more stern reproving from our elders. Because we don't have much time. And y'all just going to have to tell us like it is, and there it is. And let that seed fall where it's going to fall. So we're going to be praying for that. We're going to be praying for more stern rebuke from you and the elders, because we really need to get at it. And them goats need to be separated from the sheep so we can get it done. I'm just thankful. I'm just so thankful to find a man of Yahweh, which Pastor Dow does not have any letters behind his name, but yet the knowledge that he's been anointed with, won't one of them step up? Not won't none of them, one of them step up. He ain't heard. Ain't nobody answered him yet. Where are they at? Debate talk, where are you at? Huh? Where are they at? Not a one stepped up yet. Because they worried. They shaking in their boots that if they people hear this man preach, if I go debate against this man, a civil debate with this man on any subject regarding the scriptures, if my people hear him, they know they're going to lose some. They know they're going to lose something. And speaking of that, losing something, I truly hope and pray that that person that tore up that mail of that offering that a saint and his wife, the saints, sent the pastor, truly do realize, because I know they listened, I know they watched the broadcast, and I hope the word touched their heart. Those pastors preaching the truth.
Yeah.
But I truly hope that person realize you let the devil almost cause you to lose your job. The U.S. Postal Service is one of the last entities in America that still have health care, a pension, retirement. It's all we've done for. The country's almost done for. It's had its run, like Patty said, but you risk all that to tear up a letter because of the color of a man's skin. You damn fool. I hope that this has touched your heart and you have reconsidered your behavior and got yourself together. But I love Pastor. I truly do love him. I do. I love that man. What man don't even give his own children a pass? I mean, there's just so much proof and evidence that Jeremiah 3:15, I'm pointing at him. I'm looking at him, hugging, kissing his neck. I'm hearing him preach. I'm learning from him. I've learned so much. I learned about the hypocrite I was and didn't even know. You know?
Yes,
there was men that had done something to me, Elder Donnie. And as I was living my life, keeping the Sabbath all them years, but I hadn't found pastor yet, I was making plans. I was keeping up with technology. And I had me some throwaways tucked away. Because how my mouth got messed up and them teeth got knocked out and all that plastic surgery on my face, it was four men. Four men. It was me against four men. And I was left in a dumpster. And I didn't know for 10 years, I didn't know who did that to me. And I've been playing, and all this time, and my children, I only got a couple more, one more left at home that's not an adult. And I was going to get with them. I felt like I had been a man and raised my children, and now I could seek my revenge for what they did, trying to kill me. And I met Pastor Dow, and Brother Jermaine had a lot to do with that just by talking. They didn't know nothing about my past, but just by the preaching. And Brother Jermaine being a good brother, talking to me when I first came in ministry. And all that changed. I could care less. I could care less. I pray more for them men to find Yahweh before their day come.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But I love Pastor. I love my family. Yahweh is our life. That's all I talk about, think about, breathe about. I love it. I love it. And I thank the Most High for it. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Well, bless you, Brother Mike. Thank you for calling in and sharing that with us. Appreciate that.
Bless you, Elder.
Bless you.
Shalom.
Shalom. All right. Thanks, Brother Mike, there. Ohio. All right.
Get ready.
Let's see. I'm muted. All right, here we go. Next, we're going to area code 347. 347. You're here on the Blog Talk Radio, whatever, Straightway Truth. Elder Donnie, how can I help you?
Shalom, Elder.
Hey.
Amen. Bless you.
Shalom. Bless you, my brother.
Oh, you know, I'm just being obedient, you know, to my leaders. You know, I could say so much, Elder, about Pastor and, you know, all the men of Yah. And, you know, I came in the way, you know, I came to the knowledge of the truth that I was Israel, and we didn't have to keep these laws, and we've been lied to at 18 going on 19. Then I came to the ministry at 19. And, you know, youth is vanity. And it's nothing but a distraction. That's all youth is. And then to have someone like Pastor to tell you what youth is, to you know, be an example of hard work and what responsibility, function, what life is about, and what's an Israelite all about. And it's just a blessing, Elder, that I have men like Pastor and the elders to save me a lot of steps and a lot of trouble, that I don't have to experience all that pain.
Yes, sir.
And,
sir.
You know, Elder, I could go on all day, and the more I grow, the more I learn, the more wisdom I apply, the more I'm going to have comprehension on what it is, on the example of Pastor. I could only speak to you on the level of understanding I'm at right now.
Yes, sir.
And it's just what a blessing, and it's just inspiring to me. You know, when I see Pastor preach, when I see him make the videos, you know what I mean, the passion, I love it. You know, I just it's just so much inspiration. You know, it just light a fire in me. to become a greater man, you know. And I tell myself all the time, you know, Pastor, just, man, what a blessing.
Okay. Yes, sir.
He just inspired me to be a great man.
Yes, sir, bro. Yes, sir.
And I know that the more I grow and the older I get, the stronger the testimony is going to get.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you so much. Thank you so much, Elder, for your example, all the elders, Elder Becker, the chief elder who's behind the scene. Thank you so much, Teacher Shane. All yourself, all the other elders, Elder Spinney, Elder Austin, Elder Rufus, Pastor Tatum, Pastor Corey, Pastor Joe Fox, for being that example and for loving me enough to tell me the truth. Hallelujah. That's all I have.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, bless you, Brother Ingme. Beautiful song first. Bless you. Shalom, shalom. Right. Hallelujah. All right, that was two beautiful calls there. Three beautiful calls there, rather. Man, I keep hearing, let's see where that's coming from. That's eBay. Oh, that's. There we go. All right. So, if we're going to move on. In the, Let's see. One second, Saints. Okay. All right, we're going to go from there. We're going to go to area code 936. I'll tell you what, though, before we go there. Yeah, we'll go there. We'll go to area code 936. 936, you're on... Straightway Truth radio broadcast here on Blog Talk Radio.
Shalom, Elder Donnie. How you doing? Brother Chris here.
Blast, Brother Chris. Shalom.
Yeah, shalom. I thought I'd come on here finally for the first time, well, since you've taken over the broadcast, and say, ask how you doing. See how you doing anyway.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Blessed, man. I am blessed, Brother Chris. I truly am. Hallelujah. You doing all right?
Well, oh, yes, sir, definitely. I'm just walking around out here enjoying this Texas heat.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Sir. Yes, sir. But I just called to have a little bit of a testimony also and thank Pastor myself.
Yes, sir. Go right ahead.
Anyway, over these past few weeks, I'll say this. Work at my... ever since, I guess, Pentecost? That's beginning of May. Work at my job's been getting a bit slim, and I've been getting a bit behind on a few things. Anyway, I know it was really the devil trying to attack me all along, and fears tried to start creeping in. But basically what I did was I knew I had to start finding some new work around. Basically, what I started doing was applying to a lot of jobs, and fear started getting a little tight on me, or fears had started to get a little tight on me, excuse me, but I just received my spirit one day, fast, like, okay, and I'll tell you, lo and behold, about 9 a.m. that morning, I had two jobs hitting me with job offers.
And that's something. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. But I'll tell you this also. Just going back and thinking over and reviewing Pastor's messages, his most previous Shabbat,
sir.
Believe it or not, he actually gave us one of the ultimate discernment tools to discern if any thoughts were good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
The very definition of the very Hebrew definition of evil.
Yeah.
I mean...
Sir.
Compare that with Torah, oh boy. You can knock any thought out of the park.
Oh yeah.
Or any temptation out of the park. I got to say, I thank you. I thank all the elders, especially Elder Becker, Teacher Shane, Pastor, heck yeah, especially even Brother Mitch.
Yes.
And all the pastors around. I mean, all of y'all have helped me immensely grow within the faith. I mean heck, without the Most High leading me here, I mean, I'd been lost. I'll tell you that much for darn sure.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Well, I'll go ahead and let you get on with the broadcast, but bless y'all.
Hallelujah. Bless you. You know, it was good hearing from you, Brother Chris. It really, really was good hearing from you, man. You know, I hadn't spoke to you in a while, but you heard I mentioned how, you know, we used to be up late at all them late hours and the wee hours of the night just fellowshipping together, man. I know you remember
that. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oh, yes, sir. I remember that like it was yesterday.
Hallelujah. So, well, bless you, man. It's good to hear from you. You stay encouraged, man. You continue in that fight.
Yes, sir.
Man. Continue with that zeal
and
that. Yes, sir. Against Satan's kingdom. So, but bless you, brother. Shalom, shalom.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Shalom.
Hallelujah. Brother Chris there. Hallelujah. So, saints, it's obvious. I mean, you can tell that, you know, the brethren have been touched and their lives have been impacted, you know, by, you know, the ministry straightway. You know, led by Pastor Dow, and it's just, you know, we all, you know, can feed off each other, and we all you know, have a part, you know, in this growth and in this walk. So it's just beautiful. I'm just thankful for all of my brethren. I really am, and we're gonna continue on, and I'll go. Let's see. All right, area code 609. You're on Straightway Truth, Blog Talk Radio, Elder Donnie. Go ahead. How can I help
you? Shalom, shalom, Elder. How you doing?
Oh, bless. Shalom, shalom to you, brother.
Hallelujah. This is Brother Lucius here.
Yes, Brother Lucius.
Yes, sir. Well, yes, go ahead, sir.
No, I was just seeing how you were doing today.
I'm doing well. I just wanted to call in and pretty much say thank you to Pastor. Also, when I heard about the faith and listening, it was like a really it was a wake up call for me. And just that time in my life, I needed to hear, you know,
mm-hmm.
what I heard. And you know, I was, you know, I grew up in church, and at one point in my life, I just got through with churches. I just thought the whole thing was like a sham. You know, it was all about the money making. Thing, you know, and you know, I was just through with that stuff. So, you know,
yes,
and
sir.
listening to Pastor, that was like fresh. I can't describe you know, what I heard when I first listened to him. But you know, I'm so thankful for the Father just leading me in that direction. When I first heard him, one of the things I was really concerned about him and his life, you know, because I'm like, how he get away with talking these things without somebody hurting him.
Yes, sir.
Well, now I understand a little bit better than I did then, you know, that, you know, he is doing the Father's will, and he's doing what the Father asked him to do. And, I mean, it's just, every time I listen to him, it's just a breath of fresh air. It's just, you know, the Father speaking right through him. And I mean, our lives were just a mess in before we met, before we started listening to the pastor. And I'm telling you, it's just, I'm really grateful for Straightway, for the ministry, for, you know, every elder, every teacher. I mean, I don't understand how, you know, people find time to listen to other go to other sources to listen to stuff, because I mean, we got a full plate over here.
Oh yeah.
But I also wanted to thank Brother Randy.
Mm-hmm.
In that you know, my testimony is one of those where I do construction work. I'm working in an area where Brother Randy lives. And Home Depot is like 10-15 minutes away from his house. I was closer to him than Home Depot.
Sure.
I said, you know what, let me just run to his house. I needed a piece of PVC pipe. I said, let me just run to his house to get a piece of PVC pipe and, you know, get the job done so I could get out of there fast.
Yeah.
Man, Elder, I went to the Randy house, and he had me held up for about 2 hours. just talking about the faith of the pastor. Do I have a pastor? I don't know what he was talking about. But I just wanted to thank him also for just leading me in that direction. And, you know, my whole life has been really, really, really different from then. And, you know, I just said all that to say it's so important for us as individuals to, you know, be able to tell someone else
mm-hmm.
about our pastor, to tell someone else, to lead them in that direction.
Sure.
Because who knows what people are going through at, you know, at that in their lives at that point, you know?
Yes.
But I don't want to keep you too long, Elder. I know there's a lot of callers on the line, and I'm not a long talker either. So I just wanted to say thanks. I can't thank Pastor enough. I can't thank him enough for what he's doing. I can't thank Straightway enough for all of you that are doing what you are doing. I can't thank and encourage you all enough. Just keep it up, all elders. Keep it up. I really appreciate you. I really appreciate everything that you are doing. And I'm happy to be part of this cult. I am so happy to be part of this cult. Thank you so much, Elder.
Hallelujah.
Shalom.
Shalom, shalom. Hallelujah. That's Brother Lucius there. Hallelujah. Thank you, brother, for calling in. That was beautiful. Truly it was. All right. Brother Lucius, let's see. All right, we're going to keep it going here. Area code 270. You're on the air on Straightway Truth Radio. How can I help?
Shalom, Elder. It's Brother Ron.
All right, shalom, Brother Ron. Bless
shalom.
You.
I just want to call in. Blessings to you, too, Elder. I just wanted to call in and give thanks to my shepherd, as well as the chief elder, Becker, and the elders that have been given to us from the Father. Pastor, you know, I remember he said one time, he said, in one of the teachings, he said, when he was preaching, and, you know, he always brings that fire, so, you know, when he says something, it hits you because the Spirit hitting you right there. And he said, see, you think you know Yah, but you don't know him.
Mm.
Don't know him. He said that, and that's always stuck with me. And the reason why I bring that up is because, you know, before I was in the, before the Father led me to Straightway, you know, I was searching for the truth and, you know, looking all over the place and you know, went through so many doctrines because, you know, when the Father came, he came, he knocked on my door and just broke everything down, what I considered to be life. You know, he took it all away, and then it's like, all right, well, where do I go from here? And, you know, I tried to do the best that I could and get as far as I could. But when I met Pastor, it clearly is true, you know, you need a pastor. You know, you can only get but so far without a pastor. But what I wanted to say is about him when he said that was he said, you know, you don't know him. And we have a love for the Father. We truly do love the Father in our heart. But, you know, when he brings these teachings across, you learn how much you don't know about the Father and how much you think you love him, but you don't love him.
Mm.
And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for when that's revealed to me every time, because through Teacher Shane, through these teachings, the Father is giving us the chance to actually truly love him. He's actually given us a chance to truly love him after our, you know, our stiff-neckedness, our hard-headedness, which we still have in us, and the fact that he's given us these gifts, especially a pastor, to be able to get close to him.
Hmm.
You know, I can't put it in words. When I look at pastor, I look at him as a father. I look at him as a friend. I look at him as my shepherd. There's so many, you know, when I look at him, I look at him in so many different ways.
Yes.
You know, it's... And the main thing is, when I see him, when I see Pastor, what I see is I see the love of the Father.
Hmm.
And the love of the Father that he's bringing us back to him. That's what I see when I see Pastor. I see the Father drawing us back to him as well. And that's, you know, I just wanted to say that. And I thank Pastor for giving his life and being there to continue to do the work for the Father, to continue to give us guidance to get back to him, because we do have a love for him, but we don't know how to love him. And I thank Pastor for teaching us and showing us how to love him and showing us how to be men and showing us how to walk this faith and continuing how to actually grow. So that's what I wanted to say. And bless you out and bless your household. And bless all Israel, and I thank Yah for my family that he's given me, true family.
Yes, sir.
The real family that, you know, that we, the real family that we were actually predestined to be with, and I thank Yah for leading me here. So that's all I wanted to say, and shalom, outer.
Hallelujah. Shalom, brother. Bless you, man. Hallelujah. That was Brother Ron. He spoke well. He hit a lot of good points. Hallelujah. Blessings, brother. Hallelujah. All right, Saints. We're going to go over to the next call here. Area code 205-205. You're on the air here, Straightway Truth, on Block Talk Radio. Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom. Shalom, Brother Victor.
Shalom, Brother Victor.
Right. Shalom, Elder. Can you hear me okay?
I can hear you loud and clear, sir. You're coming in well. Blessings to you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Giving all honor and glory to the Most High Yah. Yes, hallelujah. Sir. Hallelujah. How you doing today, Elvis?
Oh, I'm blessed, man. I'm blessed. I really truly am, man. I just can't say enough, man. I'm just, I'm thankful, man. Hallelujah. Glory to the King.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It was good to see your face this morning. Real good to see your face this morning. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Sir.
No, go ahead. You're good.
Okay. Elder Dunn, I appreciate this this blog talk that you have dedicated to Pastor. I remember it was about almost four years ago when I met Pastor. And some of the first words he said to me was a rebuke.
Yeah.
Right off the top. After he got done preaching, he came right out of the pulpit and came right over to me, and I got a rebuke. And I thank him for it.
Yes, sir.
And it's stuff like that that makes me appreciate Pastor. Maybe like my second or third time meeting Pastor Dow, he offered to help me. He really extended his hand out to me. He really truly did, and I knew it was from his heart. It was like my second or third time meeting him. He was there to help me out, and I will never forget that. And Elder Dunn, you said something earlier when you were speaking. You brought out in the word how it says, forsake not his ministers.
Sir.
And I appreciate the teachings and the lessons that Pastor is bringing forth, because I can tell that Pastor, like, he wants the brethren to have a stronger relationship together. He wants the brother to really be close together. I remember when he brought, he stood one of her brothers up, Brother Darrell. He stood him up in front of the congregation, and he was hugging Brother Darrell. He was like, you know, it shouldn't be no fear in between us brothers. It shouldn't be no fear. And I can tell the way that Pastor Dial is trying to get us to go. Hallelujah. But Elder Dunning, I'm not eloquent with words. Not at all. It's probably been about 2 or 3 years since I called into a blog talk.
Are you doing fine?
Yes, sir. But I wanna repeat some of the words that Pastor Dial said in his sermon. If that's okay, Elder.
Yes, sir, that's fine. Go right ahead, sir.
Yes, sir. Some of the words that Pastor Dial said, he said that it's a damn shame to live 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 years and ain't got one person on the face of this earth that you can say your soul is knitted together with.
Sir.
You hypocrites. You damn liars. Well, everybody else is the fault. Well, how about you the fault? Everybody else is full of sin. Well, how about you full of sin? Everybody else is trouble. Well, how about you trouble? All this blame shifting is not going to bring us to the place where we need to be. Because we're definitely going to need it. And then Pastor God, he said, we can't be brothers. He said, we can't be brothers. He said, we need to be friends in this wilderness experience. In this wilderness experience.
Sure.
He said, Pastor God said, because I need you to stay close to me. That's what Pastor God said. He said, I need you to stay close to me. And when we look back, I mean, how many people have betrayed Pastor Dow? How many people have left the ministry? How many people have left the assembly? How many people have left y'all? So that's what it's all about.
Yes, sir.
Pastor Dow, he went on to say that because a brother is born for adversity, and a brother will fight you. A brother will argue with you. Yes, he will, too. I mean, when we look back at these feast days, how many arguings have we witnessed among brethren? How many have we witnessed? That's what I went on to say, but a friend will sit closer than a brother. And that's why Jesus said, what a friend we have in him. Henceforth, I don't call you no more servant, but I call you friends. And Pastor Dow went on to say, he said, y'all better get this. He said, y'all better get this.
Wow.
And he said, love is stronger than pride. Love is stronger than pride. Pastor Dow, he empties himself of so much when he be up in that pulpit. And you can tell how much he loves us because he gives us so much. So much has been given to him. And Pastor Dye, he empties himself of that knowledge. to give us so we can be saved.
Yes, sir.
So we can be delivered. I got to, and these are not my words. These are not my words. These are the words from the man of Yah. Elder, may I say another?
Yes, sir.
Some words from Pastor Dow.
Yes, sir. Go right ahead.
Pastor Dow, he said, we run from this sanctification progress. He said, we run from it. He said, we get deliverance from all these things that come upon us. We get deliverance from all these things that come upon us, but we don't want to get deliverance from the spirit that keeps us separate from our brothers and our sisters. Why is that? Because we love that ill will. We love that feels. We love the way it feels. We're supposed to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. That's what I went on to say that. The second set of commandments are about how we're supposed to get along with our brothers and our sisters. The way he said that, he made it so simple the way that a child could understand it. He said the second set of commandments are about how we're supposed to get along with our brothers and our sisters. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Brother, hey, you spoke well, I tell you that. And I'm all of Israel that are listening, they heard, you know. And thanks for, you know, rehearsing those words in our ears. Because we definitely needed to hear it. So, thank you so much. You have anything else, brother?
Elder, those are not my words,
sir.
I can only like Brother Emmett said, he can only give wisdom as he has got the wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Dodd said, you listen to a wise man, you will be wise.
And
I'm here this evening to say that Pastor Dow has been the best friend to me on this earth, here and now, because he tells me about myself. He tells me about myself.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but Pastor, he just said in the past teaching, he said that a brother, you know, would kind of be reluctant to tell you about yourself. But when I passed out, no, sir, because Pastor Dow is a friend. He really truly is a friend because he tells us about ourselves. A word, the Bible says a word spoken in due season. How good is that word?
Mm.
How good is that word when it comes to you? Pastor Dow does not withhold any good. Pastor Dow does not withhold good. He does not hold it. He does not withhold his word. And Pastor Dow, if you're listening, I love you, Pastor Dow. And I love all the pastors in Israel. I love all the elders. Bless Israel. Bless Israel. That's all I got
the other day. Hallelujah. Well, bless you, brother. Thank you so much for calling in. Appreciate those words, man. And you be blessed throughout the rest of this week. And stay encouraged, all right?
Yes, sir. Bless you. Shalom.
Shalom. Right. Hallelujah. We will thank hallelujah. That was some good words. The brothers, you can see that the brothers that are calling in have truly, truly been impacted. You know, it's no secret. And I'm thankful that they actually called in, you know. It's just doing my heart well. Because it needs to be, you know, saints. I think it needs to be. You know, we as men, we should be able to give thanks and give honor, give a compliment. And we should be able to do this thing in growing closer to the Father and then to closer to each other. It's necessary. So just give y'all all the praise, honor, and glory. We're going to go to the phone lines here to the next caller. Last one in the queue here. We have 215. Area code 215. You're on Straightway Truth on Blog Talk Radio. It's Elder Donnie. How can I help you?
Shalom, shalom, my elder.
Hey, shalom, brother. Shalom, shalom.
Yes, sir. Shalom, it's Brother Tyree.
Brother Tyree, yes, sir.
Yes, Elder Donnie. I just came in. I actually got a little bit, a couple of the testimonies that I just heard, and I'm just blown away by that. I actually got to go back over, the whole show.
Yes, sir.
But I heard. I definitely heard, and I have a testimony too, Elder. Can I?
Sir.
Okay. So when I first came into this, walk. I understand why Pastor always say you have so much of Christianity influenced in you, and I never really went to church like that. And I didn't expect, I don't got no Christianity in me. What are you talking about? To myself, not even out loud, not even noticing it, but just the arrogant way about myself, I ain't got no Christianity in me. But when he started to explain about Jesus Christ, I'm like, wait a minute. I don't know this.
Hmm.
Even about evil. One of them that hit me was sadness. I said, what, sad? Evil?
Hmm.
I said, wow.
Yeah.
Dag, did you hear that? Sadness.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, oh my gosh, we definitely is. He always said we got a gauntlet.
Yes, sir.
In front of us. He said, you got a gauntlet in front of you. And it just always never click. Sometimes you hear something, but you do need to go over it again to hear it again and say, oh, okay, that's what he's talking about. And when you walk this thing out, you really see how strong Pastor is. Doing this all them years, 20-something years, you in this walk. I've been here about a year, maybe less. And I've seen people walk in and out on Straightway, and they lead a father in a heartbeat. They don't care because the offenses in their heart. And he always said that offenses is the thing that made people leave. And I'm like, offenses? Why would somebody get it? But then I started hearing them preaching. I never really got offended because I was always had this mentality, wow, this guy know me. How do he know me? I need to read that Bible to figure out how he know people like how he know people. Because he can just see, he can just know you. And I'm like, how does he know? And he's like, it's in the scriptures. I'm like, oh, yeah, I don't know Jesus, just like you said. I don't know. I've been influenced by Christianity. And that's the image I had in my head. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Sang a song, really didn't really sing a song, but, think that you're going to one of these pagan temples and, clap your hands, feel good, please forgive me, you're free. But to come on this side, where I came from, I was asking a question to myself. I said, how did I even get to Pastor Dow? And I thought about it in some kind of way. I'm like, oh, yeah, I found him. But then I thought about it, I didn't find him. He found me. He found me, It was not me that did it because I could have easily went to anything on YouTube.
Yes.
I could have just listened to him 1 minute and just cut him off and said, I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
But to really see it, and when I came over here, all the thoughts that was running through my head, I was getting thoughts like, you can't do this. You can't do this. You just go ahead. You might as well just... give it up. And I heard the thought, and I said, what? Give it up? I said, hell is on the other side of this. Mm. Why am I getting thoughts of giving up? And this is hell on the other side. You can't really give up when it's hell on the other side. And I said, oh, this is the walk. And then once I got the testimonies and once I heard Pastor say, y'all ready to go to school? And I remember my dream that I had when I was a little boy. And I had it more than one time. I said, oh, this is where I'm supposed to be at. This is where the cup in my life that was not filled, that I kept looking for something, kept trying to eat as much food as I want, kept trying to get as much pleasure as I want out of life, even money. I was hustling, doing all types of stuff. It didn't even fill me up. I was so unhappy. I was so unhappy. I was so unhappy. I was so miserable. I was so saddened. And I was just good by the world term is good. Give to the homeless. Walk around, talk to people. Never looking at myself, really, because even when I looked at myself, I really wasn't looking at myself until I really had to think about it. Every time I spoke to somebody, do I judge myself in them same manners?
All right.
I said, wow. So I coming into this, it changed my whole life. It's like I was asleep, and I woke up. And I've just never been asleep. I'm like, wait a minute. It's so clear now. It's clearer. Like, I see things now. I'm like, how did I fall for that? Mm-hmm. I mean, I kept falling for things that everybody else fall for, whether it's Christmas, Easter, my children celebrating it, all of these different holidays, the ways I was acting. Even hiding myself, the word find me all the time. Hiding myself. You go to Christianity, you're going to get a bunch of people, don't judge. Don't judge. Don't judge me. But this word, he's a bloodletting. It really tears you up because it finds you. It finds you out. It definitely finds you out. And as it finds you out, you either can look at yourself and like it and change, or you can look at yourself and get mad at the person that you're listening to and try to blame it on them, which is idiotic, but sometimes it's like that for people. So, you know, LDOT, it turned my whole life around. And I'm dying every day, and every day, I still don't know nothing. I'm still don't know nothing. And I just want to know. I just want to know. And my heart is so much into, wow, I want to know. I need more to know. I've been asking the Holy Spirit, well, you know, I need more time. Do you know every morning, probably like 3 o'clock in the morning, I just wake up? I'm like, I'm just waking up.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow, I just woke up. Like, no alarm clock, just waking up. I'm like, this is really helpful. In my household, I was so much of a piece of crap dad and a husband. Oh, man, when I walked over here, it was like, wow, that's awesome, man. That's the best thing I ever did for my family, the best thing I did for myself. It was the best thing I did in my entire life was to listen. I'm 28 years old. I thought I knew a lot. I thought I was at least smart. I'm the bottom of the bottom.
Yeah,
I'm like, wow. Pastor, listen to this. Listen to this, Pastor. This is how good. We were celebrating all these holidays and stuff, and we didn't care about the Father. We were doing our thing. Still in misery, still in sin all day long. Listen to this now. I couldn't even do this before, but I can do this at the break of the dawn and listen to my household. Listen to this. Glory!
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
They love the Father. They sang songs. I told my son to say glory. I say glory, say hallelujah. We all gonna say it together. Spirits be getting tore up in here because this little boy would just be out of nowhere. Glory. You just like, oh, okay, glory, and don't think that he's about to stop. 10-20 times he about to do it. Yeah, he gonna find something's gonna find you out. And I say, who want to sit here and tell this little boy not to say glory or hallelujah? Who want to say it?
That's right. Right.
That's what the ministry did to me. I never met nobody in my life like Pastor Dowd. Don't hold no punches. Not at all. Like the brother just said, a true friend to us all. I never had a friend. That's right. The only friend I actually got. And I had to learn how to be a friend to the person that's already being a friend to me.
That's right.
I gotta learn how to be a friend of him because he's so much a friend of me. And I love this walk. My body don't. I love this walk. My spirit loves this walk. It loves this walk because it really shows me, like, this thing that I've been feeling in my heart, and it's something I've been feeling down deep in. See, this is so right. This is the best thing in life, to be able to follow Jesus Christ. I mean, the real Jesus Christ. To be able to look at yourself on a daily basis and die and change. I pick food up slower now. I look at, we in the stores looking at every ingredients. What's that? We're not getting that. We starved. My whole family starved the first month when we found our pork ribs and everything.
Oh, wow.
We all lost pounds. We didn't know what to do. We just didn't want to do it no more. I had to say, no, we're not doing anything in my household, no. I don't care what bread is, don't pick that in your mouth. Don't put that in your mouth. Because the fear of Yahweh came upon me, and it was beautiful. Because by the time I had a fear of something other than death, because I was so afraid of death, not know where am I going there. In this ministry, not in this ministry. The pastors, the elders, every time coming in hitting, I listened to Pastor one Sabbath. I looked above him and I said, look at that. He is a puppet for the Most High. Like I could see a hand just moving him. I said, every time I hear the elders, even when I hear the brothers, if I listen closely, I can listen past and I can say, I can know when I'm listening to the Father.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless you all. I'm not gonna hold it up, but what can I say? If you find something about this ministry over here, it usually you found yourself, and that's what you're running from. You didn't find nothing wrong with this ministry. You found something wrong with yourself, and that don't mean everybody is perfect. But it definitely tell you that you definitely found something wrong with yourself, and you trying to hide yourself. And I'm not about hiding myself, because I've been hiding myself my entire life. To be able to come out with a bunch of saints that's willing to kill off the old man and be able to help each other kill off the old man.
Mm-hmm.
I got reproved. I'm not going to say rebuked, because it wasn't sharp. I got rebuked by Pastor Dow. I didn't even realize it. I listened to him and I was talking about my mother. I got off the phone and the phone had messed up. He said, y'all don't even know who your mother is. Y'all just discombobulated. I didn't even realize it. I'm smiling and happy. It took me a while to think about it and say, oh, yeah. Wow. I don't. I didn't know how to treat my mothers or understand who is my mother. You understand? I'm like, wow, this is a trip. This world ain't nothing but the devil. Ain't nothing but the devil in this world, because that's what I function after. And if I'm evil as I don't know what, if I'm walking around here and I'm functioning after my own nature, these are the natures I learned from my flesh and blood family.
Sir.
These are natures I picked up on my own, following, being a whore to the house of time.
Sir.
And now I don't have to say that anymore. I know better now. And I'm still learning. And it's not over, because I'm still messing up. But guess what? I'm still learning.
Sure.
And I'm not giving up.
Sure.
So bless all of Israel. I love you, Pastor. I love all of Israel.
Hallelujah.
Keep up the fight. Keep bloodletting. Keep killing the flesh. And I thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, thank you, brother, for your call tonight, and it's greatly appreciated. And glory to the King. Bless you, brother.
Glory to the King.
Hallelujah.
Shalom, shalom.
All right, that's Brother Tyree. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, we're going to go ahead to the last caller here. Area code 615. All right, we got Brother Mike back in the queue. Go ahead. You're on Straight Radio, Blog Talk Radio. Go ahead, Brother Mike.
No, this is Brother Vernon. Shabbat Shalom.
I'm sorry.
Elder, how are you? Shabbat Shalom, Elder.
Yeah.
Shalom, Shalom, Elder. All of Israel and the saints scattered abroad. Oh, mercy. Elder, there has been so many beautiful calls and testimonies here tonight. And I probably sound like a tape recorder to go through everything that I wanted to say, because, you know, a lot of the brothers said exactly the things that I wanted to say about Pastor Dow, Elder Becker, and the elders, even some of the heads of the assemblies. But I'm not going to be long. I'm not going to be long. I'm going to just say this. A lot of people, a lot of the brothers and sisters probably don't know my testimony. But to make it short, I was in the world gambling, smoking, drinking, doing the whole gamut. I'm chasing death so hard. 4 years ago, it was unreal. I was just working to support my pleasures. Mm-hmm. I mean, taking care of my household first, of course, but everything else was going toward my pleasures. Giving all glory and honor to the Father, He was drawing me away from this because in my spirit, I started getting sick and tired of it. It got to be more to life than this. So I called myself giving my life back to Christ, not having the true understanding that the Father was drawing me. And I went and got baptized in a Christian church, you know, because that's all I know to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was raised up in the church, so when I left the church at 17, I hadn't really stepped foot into another church until I turned 44 years old, rather. And I stepped back into the church, and I was reading Matthew, you know, being a good Christian, starting from the middle of the book.
Yes, sir.
And Jesus said these words, "Let no man deceive you." So I prayed to the Father about it. A couple days later, I'm looking up Illuminati. And out of all of the suggesting videos on the right-hand side of YouTube, there's this one video of Pastor Dow, Hebrew Israelite versus Christianity. My eyes were drawn to it. My spirit was drawn to it. And I clicked on that video, and it was a six-part series. Each part is about 10, 15 minutes long. And he said, "We're going to break down a lot of the sacred cows of Christianity. You're going to need your Bible. Go get your Bible." And in each video, he was like, "Okay, so you made it this far. So you made it this far." So I'm sure you know the video I'm talking about. And that started my journey. That was my starting point, the Father saying to me, like, I'm not comparing myself to Abraham, but when he told Abraham, "It's time to get out of your father's house," that was the beginning of my journey. And I felt that the Father was saying to me, "Okay, it's time for you to start walking this way." Mm-hmm. Put Pastor Dow in my life, and I thank him for putting Pastor Dow in my life, because if he hadn't have put Pastor Dow in my life, brother, I'm sure a lot of the other brothers can testify that I'd probably be in the gutter somewhere. Because I was running hard. So on this side, I'm trying to really get myself together and tight to run for life. Just as hard, if not more.
Yes.
Pastor Dow has been the friend to me. First and foremost, a friend to me. Before I even considered him to be my pastor, we would talk every now and then on the phone, and he would talk to me as a friend, not even talking to me as a pastor, but a friend. Showing himself friendly to me.
Sir.
The Father was working on my heart so much towards him my ex-wife was running through the gamut on the internet, finding all the negative stuff she can find out about Pastor. My spirit was drawn so much to him when I talked to him and was telling him what was going on. It fell out of my mouth. Pastor, I'm not even concerned about where you're in. You don't have to explain none of that to me, because I knew the Father put him in my life for a purpose.
Yes, sir.
Pastor Dow is the device, if for lack of a better term, that the Father used to save my life, bro.
Sir.
He has shown himself to be more of a friend to me, a brother, and a pastor and a shepherd to me. And I just want to give thanks to the Father for him. I want to give glory to the Father for all of my elders and all of the pastors affiliated with the ministry.
Sir.
Before Pastor Corey became Pastor Corey, he and I used to talk a lot. And now that he's pastor, he is the same person. We still talk.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Tatum, since we met him in Chicago, I was on that journey with Pastor Dow. Because that's how much I just wanted to be around him. Brother Jermaine and I, we was calling ourselves the Road Warriors. And Elder, I know I said I wasn't going to be long, but I tell you, I could take up the rest of this time talking about Pastor and my elders. Me and Brother Jermaine used to call ourselves the Road Warriors, because everywhere Pastor went, we just had to be there. We had to be around this man, because he was, you know, me and Brother Jermaine came into the ministry about the same time. And mm-hmm. we just had to be around this man. It was, the Father was, had some, he's like a magnet, and he was just drawing us to him. And we just had to be around this man. And I didn't understand it at first. All I know was the Father was putting this man in my life. So, just to make it short, to bring it to a close, Pastor Dow, I love you. And I'm sure what I'm about to say is that there's some brothers, a lot of other brothers in the ministry that feel the same way. I was charged to be an armor bearer by a knucklehead that is no longer with us. But when he gave me that charge, I took that charge very serious. And I still hold that charge serious today.
Sure.
And everywhere Pastor goes, I'm going to try my best to be there for that purpose. I kind of feel like that's what I'm supposed to do. Because the way I see it, my life is nothing at this point. The Father brought me here, and I feel he brought me here to do a job. Not only learn about him, but to play my part in this body. And if anywhere Pastor goes, if I can make it, I want to be there to play my part. Elder Becker, I love you, Pastor. Elder Becker, myself and Elder Becker have not had a whole lot of time to sit down and really talk and things of that nature. But I can say one thing about my elder, my chief elder. He's a very loving man as well. Not knowing me from Adam, he has stood up and fought for me when it came to dealing with an outside knucklehead. He has reproved and regrouped me in the times that it was very pertinent to be done. And it really brought to me the realization of the ministry and the walk that I was walking. And I thank him for that, because I was acting very childish at the time. You know, always, you come in, you know, you want to get to know everybody and get in good with them, and you're joking a lot. And I was joking a lot.
Sure.
And he set me back at ground zero, and that's what I needed at the time. But you and I, we got history.
Yes,
you know, we used to, how we used to get together and study the word before you became an elder and things of that nature. And Elder Rufus, before Elder Rufus, he was at the Chicago trip. And, you know, he and I got Elder Frank, mm-hmm. Elder Austin.
Yes.
We haven't had a whole lot of time to really sit down, but from the time I met Elder Austin, I've never, like Pastor said, I've never had a crooked bone in my body towards him.
Right.
I mean, how can you have a crooked bone in your body toward Elder Austin? He don't, quiet, confident, strength.
That's right.
The epitome of Isaiah 30:15. I love the man for it. I got to take my hat off to the Texas Saints, Brother Mitchell and Brother Greg.
Yes, sir.
Man, there's so many places I can go. I just love my family, and I tell you, it's like Pastor said, you mess with one of those in my family, I'm coming to see you. I'm coming to see you. And the only man that's going to slow me down is Pastor Dow, for instance. Last thing I'm going to say. When this Pastor Ron came up to the land talking about he was going to have some fun with Sister Carol.
Sir.
If Elder Becker, he had just told me, Pastor said, don't hurt the man, because I already had it set. If this booger show up at this door, he's going to get a beat down. You
yeah.
know what I mean?
Yeah.
And Elder Becker just told me, Pastor said, don't hurt him. Don't hurt him. And as soon as I turned around, he walked through the door. And I wasn't quite sure it was him, so I tapped Brother Bell. Is that him? Oh, Brother Bell went straight to him, and then I jumped into it. And I had to pull myself back because I was getting kind of hyped. Because, you know, he's so little, I was about to pick him up and just carry him on to the end of the land and throw his butt. But
yes, sir.
I just thank you all for being in my life. At this point on this side of walking for life, you all have been great mentors in molding who I am today. I tell you, I love Israel. I truly love Israel. And following Pastor Dow, I have also learned that loving Israel is also a form of loving the Father, because you can't love the Father if you don't love the people. Hallelujah. Bless you, Elder. And again, I want to give all glory to the Father.
That's right.
Because without him, none of this is possible.
That's right.
Bless you, Elder. Bless Hallelujah. You, Elder Becker. Oh, I cannot forget. Elder Frank. Elder Frank. I got to say this. Pastor once called myself and Elder Frank the Sons of Thunder. And I tell you, we used to talk on the phone all the time. And, you know, I called him a couple of days ago, and he returned my call today. Man, you know, it was so good to talk to Elder Frank. I miss him so much. And
sure.
I just wanted to throw a shout-out to Elder Frank to let him know, you know, we love you, man, and we miss you. Can't wait to hug your neck again. Come on back and see us. Hallelujah. Bless you, Elder.
Bless you.
Shalom,
man. Shalom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's our brother there, Brother Vernon. Hallelujah. Touched on so many good points as well. Oh, man, I tell you, it's clear, it's obvious, man, that these men in Israel have truly been touched. Glory to the King. I'm just so so thankful. You know, Brother Vernon touched on a couple of things, too. I wanted to, and I wanted to do this individually with all the elders, but because, you know, they all are special to me, you know, and I really, truly, I'm going to do something. I'm going to still do it. I get the opportunity through this broadcast and just to give them a shout out. But I really, truly, I want to give thanks to Elder Rufus. Coming into this walk, you know, Elder Rufus didn't even know me, man. And this is one of the things that really made me see that how serious people around here were. You know, he came and talked with me. We sat on the bench together. I mean, just poured it all out to me. Didn't even know me. And I was just blown away by it. And ever since that time, you know, the Rufus has not changed. You know, he's grown, but the way he treats me is just the same way, man, you know. And you can count on him for that. He cares about Israel. I mean, deeply cares about the saints. And Elder, I really, really want to thank you for being a brother, you know, for being a friend. Whenever I have questions and things that I don't, you know, understand, or just, you know, Elder Rufus, he sticks his neck out there. It's no secret. You know, he does things, and I thank him for it. And then he goes right back and he teaches me and he shows me, okay, this is what I did here and there. And, you know, and I can't thank him enough for that. A true brother, a true friend. I really do. And, you know, Elder Austin, man, you know, you said it, Brother Vernon, but this brother here, whenever I'm around him, I could just be myself, you know. He's just really down to earth, just really, just a powerful brother, really, truly, just to be around. I mean, I don't even have the word to describe it, but he's genuine, loves the Father. He's obvious of that, and he just got it together, and we thank the Father for him. And my brother, Elder Spinney, you know, just being there, you know, as a brother, you know what I mean? I'm just so grateful for you, you know. You know, we sit there and we talk and we share all the time, week to week. And I thank the Father, I really do. I thank the Father for you, man, you know. I just want to continue to grow with you and we move forward in Messiah, you know. Elder Frank, you know, man, you talk about somebody who care about you. This brother would call it straight. I'm going to just be honest with y'all, Saints. He would just get on me. Just rebuke me, man. And I, you know what I mean? He was right on. How can you buck up against when a person is just right, you know? Not even worrying about being wrong or not even being fearful at all. Just coming, talking to a brother. Hey, you know, and I appreciate that. I really appreciate it. And I dearly miss you too as well, brother. Just it's always a joy to speak with you. And I thank the Father for you. I think I got all the elders. Pretty that I did. Saints, this has been a broadcast. I tell you. And you see why it was necessary. You know, this is a lot of brothers who may not have had a chance to say it, or, you know, hadn't gotten around to it, were able to express the way they felt, you know, and the testimonies and way this ministry has impacted their lives. And that's what it's all about. You know, we have something special here, and we really need to thank the Father for it and be grateful for it. And not only that, but you know the messages that go forth, you know, the rebuke, the correction, the admonishment. We need to take heed to every bit of it and allow it to help in transforming our minds and as we grow in Messiah. I'm going to read something to you, Saints, and I won't hold you long. The blessings to all the heads of the assemblies out there. I'm going to go ahead and read this real quickly. It says, the spiritual life does not void any enjoyment to the person himself. It is instead a life of daily fighting. To remove warfare from spiritual life is to render it unspiritual. Life in the spirit is a suffering way, filled with watching and laboring, burdened by weariness and trial, punctuated by heartbreak and conflict. A spiritual life is one of spiritual usefulness because it is lived to mount assault upon assault against Yah's spiritual enemy. We ought to be zealous for Yah, relentless, attacking the enemy and never allowing this most useful spirit of ours to sink into passivity. Saints, it's been a beautiful broadcast. Unfortunately, I have to end it now, but I pray that you are encouraged by these words. Let's take heed to all that's coming forth. You know, Yahweh really cares for us. He loves us. And it's obvious by what he's given us, the gifts, I should say. So you be encouraged throughout the week, Saints of the Most High. Continue to pray, continue to fight, continue to war. Hallelujah. Yes, sir, Brother Vernon. I'll let but bless you all, Saints. In the mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, always remember, give Yah the praise, give him the honor and the glory. In Jesus' name, bless y'all. Shalom, shalom.
look at him looking.